Hey everyone, welcome back to JR Pro Shop Vids. We're at the end of 2021. We thought, what better time to update our six ball arsenals? Last week we released a video about the best balls of 2021. So with that being said, we want to do our six ball arsenal, what we would bring to a tournament if we didn't know what the oil pattern was, we didn't know what the lane surface was, just a good mix of bowling balls that it doesn't matter what the conditions are, we're going to have a shot.
All right, Jung, we're going to start with you. I'll go next and we'll finish off with Jimoo. So we got a righty, a lefty, and a two-hander. And with that being said, let's start with you.
Let's get into it. Jungle's here, we'll start it off with my six ball arsenal. At the top of the bag with the X1 and the X2 from Rotogrip, absolute great 1-2 punch, especially in the longer patterns and heavier oil. Usually have my X1 around 2,000, 1,500, and then the X2 at box finish, and they work really good together on the longer patterns. In the middle of my bag here, I got the Phase 2 pin in the ring and a pin down idle. The Phase 2 is really aggressive, hooks a lot, just not as much as the X1 though. So medium patterns, maybe even short, this would look really good. Really even, smooth, covers a lot of boards. And then just below that, we got the famous idle here. Hooks about 3 to 4 boards less than the Phase 2. It works on lots of different patterns, burned up long, medium, short after there's been a few games bowled on it. And then at the bottom of my bag here, I got the brand new Wolverine from 900 Global. A really, really good ball for when the lanes are burned up. Lots of games on the lanes. And you need a ball to get through the heads and really turn the corner down lane. So I was really happy with this one when I threw it maybe 3 to 4 weeks ago. And yeah, it made the bag. It really did. And then urethane, of course, we got the fast pitch. I like this one because it just hooks a little bit more than the pitch black. And I get a lot more use out of it. And when I'm traveling, I use it for spares as well. So just drilled a fresh one of this. You can tell it's still got the lines on it. Really good urethane ball. Always have one with me. Well, right now, the X1 has the most amount of games on it. You can see the logos are kind of fading here. This is my go-to ball lately because we've been bowling lots of oil and longer patterns. So I've been using that a lot. The idle, X1 and the idle, my two favorite balls. And they get the most use. Why not? They're my favorite. I like the way they look going down the lane. I like the way they react. So why not, right? Why play with something you don't know what's going to do? So with that being said, these balls are really good because I have thrown every single ball that's been made by 900 Global, Rotogrip, and Storm this season. So for these six to make my bag, they really did outperform the other balls, I think, by a wide margin. If I were to bring 8 balls to a tournament, say I was driving, and I could bring as many balls as I wanted, I would probably throw in a spare ball, just because I know it's going dead straight, bowling lots of games, I don't have to worry about any of that, and I could keep the surface on my fast pitch, you know, just in case. And then I would probably bring an IQ Tour that would fit right in here. Would hook just a little bit less than the idle, but cover a little bit more boards than the Wolverine and a little smoother. So that's the gap I would fill if I were to bring another reactive. Where the top end of my bag here, X1, X2, Phase 2, pretty much set. Doesn't really matter what the pattern is, long, medium, lots of oil. I can find something with these three. Hopefully this helps. Hopefully this gives you some insight into Jungo's bag and what I like to see going down the lane. And next up, Barks. Let's see what he's got from Brunswick and Hammer.
Hey guys, we heard from Jung about what his six ball arsenal is going to be. Mine's going to be a little bit different. As a lefty, the breakdown is a fair bit different than it is on the right side, so you're going to see me gravitate to some stronger bowling balls. So let's start at the top end, the Hammer Obsession. Considered putting a Quantum Evo Solid in this spot as well. Both kind of read the mid lane really early and really dig into the oil. I just get a little bit more shape out of the Obsession Solid here, so that kind of matches my eye a little bit better, especially on the longer patterns. Moving on to the next ball, especially for the flatter patterns, I really like the Obsession Tour. So this ball is not quite as strong as an Obsession Solid. That being said, when it's really flat, it gives me a little bit more room for error and I can get a more predictable ball motion out of it. Step down from that is the Damn Good Verge by DV8. Out of box, they're very similar as far as how they read the lane. Now for me, I like to take the surface down a little bit, so this one's at about 3,000. Now for me, that gives me a little bit more length through the front part of the lane and a little bit more shape down lane to give them a little bit more separation. So the next ball down the line is my trusty Hero Solid. So it really digs into the mid lane and it's really smooth off the end of the pattern. This is a ball that I throw a lot on fresher conditions when I really want to control the pocket. So the next ball in the line is the Obsession Tour Pearl. It's not necessarily weaker than all the others, but it has a pearl cover stock. It's good when I start to break down the pattern a little bit and I need more length through the front part of it. I consider putting a ball like a bonus pearl in here, but sometimes that ball can be a little too long and miss the spot a little bit or jump off a little too hard. It's a little bit more unpredictable. I like how predictable this is for a pearl ball, so that's why I'm going to throw it in here. And of course, at the end of the bag, we got the trusty Purple Hammer. throw it a lot on short patterns, even some medium ones as well. It also doubles as my spare ball. As a lefty, I'm gonna throw urethane a lot more than the righties do, so it's good to have a ball like this that I really trust. As Jordan sort of talked about, if we were driving somewhere, we were gonna expand this to 8 balls. Now, I don't have a polyester spare ball, so we're not gonna add that. So a couple balls I'm missing, a symmetric pearl, like I mentioned before, the bonus pearl. With a little bit of surface taken off, that ball's really shiny out of the box. It's not my favorite as it comes, but with a little scuff, it gives me a much more consistent shape. And if we're gonna add one more, I usually err towards the top end of the bag. I'm gonna put a Proof Hybrid right in here. It's another ball I use on long patterns. It's not quite as strong as the Obsession, but there is a bit of a gap here. It gives me a little bit more length and a little more shape than the Obsession Solid. So we got our thoughts from the righty and the lefty. Let's talk to the two-hander and see what he has to say.
Jimoo's back, or the two-hander, as Bark said. This is my arsenal. Let's go over it. Top of the line, big boy, Proton Physics, strong ASIM solid bowling ball. It's my big tank. I use it on long patterns, mainly the fresh for medium, long. It's super strong, gives me a good reaction if I wanna play it fast and stay right and control the oil pattern until it breaks down. Going off that, I got trusty Phase 2. It's one of the best bowling balls on the market for a reason. It smells great, it looks great, and what I like about it is it's very smooth, and in the back end, it still gives me enough pop down lane for when I wanna move in or if I wanna stay out. Moving off the Phase 2, my trusty IQ. If you were here for our last Arsenal vid 1 year ago, the IQ was still there. It made it all the way for another year because this ball is just so smooth, so predictable, so controllable on every type of pattern I throw it on. Logo is fading for sure, but that's only because it gets a lot of use and I use it as my benchmark bowling ball. Next up, UC3, Rubicon UC3. This is a pearl asymmetric urethane bowling ball. If you didn't see our last video, I compared it to some other urethane bowling balls. I really like the pop that it gives down lane on the medium and the short patterns. It's able to hold its line for long enough and then give me a nice strong back end into the pocket. And moving just slightly off of that, trusty purple hammer. This pearl urethane has a symmetric core. It's a bit smoother than the UC3, but still strong and gives enough back end compared to something like the pitch black. Usually my go-to ball for short and medium oil patterns. It's just so predictable, it's smooth, and until the ball starts hitting flat or rolling out, when I can go to the UC3, it gives me a consistent reaction to shoot big scores. Finally, spare ball, JR Pro Shop logo, same as last year. I've kept this ball mainly because with a two-hander and the rev rate, it's too hard to control to flatten out the hand. So using this spare ball allows me to have a consistent, reliable spare shooting system where I never have to change anything. Expanding on what Jungo and Bark said, if we had the opportunity to expand to an 8-ball arsenal, I would throw my Axiom, which would fit about here. Now the Axiom, as seen in the last video, it's super smooth, super strong. It's a symmetric core, as opposed to the ASIM Proton Physics. So it doesn't change direction as hard as the Proton Physics, but it's still a strong early rolling ball. And as for the last ball, I would throw the Idol Synergy. As you can see, solid, solid, solid pearl, urethane, spare ball. Not really any shiny balls here. So later in a block, you need a ball that won't hook too early and can give you some energy in the back end. And that's exactly what my Idol Synergy does. It fits right about here and I can use it later in the block when the lane's closer to burnt. So as a two-hander, I have no problem hooking the ball, but I do need bowling balls that will help control that hook. And these bowling balls give me a consistent reaction, a reaction that I can rely on. So let's wrap it up. It's just me again. Thank you so much for watching JR Pro Shop vids and our updated arsenals for the year 2021. And our question for you today, what is your 6-ball arsenal? And if you don't have 6 balls, that's fine. Let us know what balls you would want to fill those gaps. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you so much for a great year of JR Pro Shop vids. Can't wait for 2022.